From this video lecture, we are going to discuss about the new chapter, that is control and coordination of class 10th biology. And first of all, let us define the process of control and coordination. So, control and coordination can be defined as the adequate regulation and proper adequate regulation and proper synchronization adequate regulation and proper synchronization of various body organs to produce an appropriate response against a stimulus. So, in the definition, there are two main terms given which are essential to or we need to understood about them. The first is the stimulus and then the response. So, response and stimulus, these are the two things in the definition of control and coordination. First of all, let us define about these two terms. So the first term, that is stimulus. So stimulus is the environmental change. Change or events, environmental change or events to which an organism interacts, to which an organism interacts. Is called the stimulus. While the second term, which is known as the response, can be defined as the interaction. Stimulus. The interaction is known as the response, while the environmental change to which the organism interact, these are known as the stimulus. So these two terms are essential term or the base of the control and coordination. With the help of example, we can also understood about this. Let us take an example. During the winter season, or the winter season leads to the wearing of warm cloth. So this example can explain the both, that is stimulus and response. In this case, the winter season means the season which is defined by the cold climate or cold temperature. So cold temperature or winter season is the stimulus. It is the stimulus, and against that stimulus, the wearing of warm cloth is the response of the human being, because human being is the warm blooded animal, and they have to maintain their body temperature, or their body temperature remain constant. So due to fall of temperature in winter season, the body feel low temperature in the environment, so there is need of wearing of warm cloth during the winter season. So this wearing of warm cloth is the response, while the winter season or falling of temperature during the winter season, it is the stimulus. So these are the two terms under the definition of control and coordination. So this is known as control and coordination. Coordination means when there are two factors or there are two components responsible for a function by joining together. Means two or more than two components of the living organism, when they are responsible for a particular function by involvement of all the components, means involvement of all components necessary for performing that particular function. So that situation or that process comes under the category of coordination, or that kind of feature is known as coordination. So in coordination or control and coordination, in our body, for a particular stimulus, a number of body organs coordinated together to give a particular response to or against a particular stimulus. So the process of control and coordination take place in our body, and there are two types of control and coordination especially in the case of animals. So let us define the types of control and coordination. Types of control. Types of control in our body, especially in the case of human being, there are two types of control. The first category is the nervous control, while the second is the endocrine control. Endocrine control. So nervous control is performed by the help of nerves, nerve cell or neuron and nerve fiber. These are the structure which involve in transfer messages as electrical signal or electrical impulse. In the form of electrical impulse, the messages can be transmitted with the help of nerve cell or neuron or the nerve fiber. Nerve fiber actually formed by the placing of neurons just adjacent to each other. And this nervous control is a quick process in our body, means it work very fastly than the endocrine control. And endocrine control involves the hormones, a special chemical formed in our body by endocrine gland. Hormones are the chemical messenger here. The messengers are electrical, while here the messengers are chemical, and these messengers send the messages in slow manner, slow process or slow control. We can say that the slow control which is found in our body. So these are the two types of control and coordination, or two types of system for control and coordination in the case of living body, especially in the case of animal. Because in plants there are some other strategies. Plants also produce hormone, but that are not known as the endocrine system, because on that place there is no glands, endocrine gland, for release of hormone. Hormone are synthesized at a particular place in the case of plants. And for the nervous control, there is no any system in the plant's body, so no nervous control take place in plant's body. Then one thing also we need to understood related to control and coordination, which is the result of control and coordination, that is the movement. Movements are considered as the result of control and coordination, because the stimulus creates a response in the form of movement. And the movement we have discussed in our previous class, that there are two tissues, nervous tissue and muscular tissue or muscles. These are the two components which are responsible for movement in our body. And movements can be divided into two categories: the growth movement which are mostly found in plants, for example extent of seedling. During germination, the movement of seedling considered as the growth movement. The second movement is the non-growth movement. And it is mostly found in animals. In animals, the growth non-growth movement mostly occur in the form of running, playing, singing, barking. So these are the non-growth movement. Means there is no growth occur in the case of this movement. So these are the different topics which are considered under the introduction of this chapter. And from the next video lecture, we will discuss about the main topic under this chapter, that is the control and coordination in animals and the control and coordination in plants. So in control and coordination in animals, we will discuss about the nervous control, first of all, about the detail, and then we will discuss the endocrine control in detail about various endocrine gland along with their secretion into the body to perform the various control process in our body.